I'm gonna be honest with you. You probably don't get how if-then functions work in Excel or in Notion. But you know what? I think they're a lot easier than people probably make them out to be. And I'm gonna show you exactly how to make something as complicated as this, or as this, seem really easy to your brain. So when it comes to the if-then function, it really is in a few different parts of the equation that our brain gets a little bit tripped up. So here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a checkbox, and then here I'm going to put a status property, and then here I'm gonna put a number property. Now, when it comes to a status or a text property, you're gonna have a similar thing in an if-then formula, generally speaking. So at the end of all this, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a formula that could format things in a few different ways. And basically this is gonna be a giant if-then formula that is gonna factor in all of these different types at once. So when you're worrying about factoring in other properties to an if-then formula, there's a few different ways that something can be figured out. So you do if, and then you do the property. So that's gonna be property. And then either you can click from one of these guys, or you can just put another parentheses and then type it out. So let's do checkbox, and then you have to close the parentheses, and then you do two equal signs if you wanna make it equal to. Since it is a checkbox, it's gonna be either true or false. True is gonna be it being checked off, and false is going to be it not checked off. So we do true. Then after you say if the property is true, then commas are thens. Here, you would put a quote for what you want it to spit out. So if it's true, put complete. I could put another check mark there, and then you close a parentheses. And then the last thing in any of your if-then functions is going to be a what would happen if the stuff before it isn't true. The way that the if-then functions work is that it stacks on top of each other. The first if is saying, if this happens, then this. But then if you put another one after it, that's under it. The logic starts at the top and goes down. So if I would put another comma here, I would have to put not complete, or in progress would actually be my most likely one to put here. Then I end the parentheses, or then I end the quotes and close the parentheses. And since this is not finished, it's in progress. But when it is finished, it's complete. And then if you wanted to add logic to the top of this, what you then would do is you'd put a comma before that first if. But if you wanted to add logic to the other end of this, you'd basically put it between the final then, which is sort of an else situation, because all of the logic before this final comma is the if statements. And then if none of that's true, then they're just gonna put in progress. So since we'd probably wanna have something like, if this check is checked off, it's complete, that's like the main hierarchy of the logic, I'm good with that. So then for something like this, let's put a number like 5 in here to show you how the next if function works. So if we put a if here, and then we put the property number is, after the property you put either equals to, or you can put greater than if it's a number. So we put greater than 5, or I'm gonna actually put 4 since that's the number's 5 that I put in earlier. Greater than 4, then you put a then for a comma. I'm gonna put on time, and then put a star. And then if I end the quotes, then I put a comma. If I add anything, I have to add an extra parentheses at the end of the equation. Then I put on time. So this basically says, let's pretend like this number is really days left to be done or something. Then this would tell me it's on time. I could change this name to task status, and it makes more sense here. But then say we had something like a waiting on situation here. So if I put waiting on as a new part of this property, then what I could do here is I would personally say that the logic of waiting on is above that of a on time, because if there is something that the client's not giving to you, you're gonna have to wait. So let's put a new one. So this is going to be, we put a comma at the end of that other one, and before it we put in if property, and we put status, and then equals. Then we're gonna have to put quotes again. So the quotes here are going to be, we're gonna have to put waiting on for that status property, comma, then we have to put waiting on, put a little snooze, quotes, and then make sure there's only one comma before this. Sometimes it bugs. You can see here really quick, you can't see the extra comma there, but I'm basically deleting it, and sometimes the formula kind of bugs out. If you want to like make sure that it looks good or not, you can paste this out and see what the problem is there. But if you see this order now, basically if it's complete by having this checked off, it'll pop out like that. If the property status is waiting on in the status here, it'll be waiting on. If it's greater than 4 days and the day is left, then it's on time. And if not, it's just in progress. So then if I change this to waiting on, you'll see that it switches the task status to way down. So the reason that this makes sense for a lot of things is like for my different one here, this has a bunch of different things here. This aggregates things like subtasks, whether we want to show that it's archived, whether that we actually are showing that we have a due date or not. This kind of tells me whether it has a due date or not. So if I take this example right here and I strip out when I get final assets received in zero, you can see this switches this task status to a planning one because it's telling me like, okay, there's an empty SLA due date. That means it's in the planning phase. We don't know. And then for the timeline status, which tells me like whether it's on time, late, etc., it's got no timeline. And then for when you deliver something, it also is great to show a client like, hey, delivered it here. I said that I got the final stuff here and then it was due here, which means that I delivered it on time because the completed date was this date. And this formula is probably the most advanced one out of all of them. But now that you know the basic way that the few different kinds of ones work, whether it be true or false for the checkbox, greater than, less than, or equal to for a number, or equal to some text, you can just keep stacking that and then adding a comma at the beginning or during it, and then adding a parentheses at the end and following the exact same format. If you want to learn more advanced tips on how to utilize Notion, check out this video right here.